watch fans, it's Anders here on Watch On channel. Today, a video which is a little bit different because here you see six of my personal watches from my private stash. And there's a reason why I picked these watches out of my collection, because today I wanted to do a little bit of a different video. I wanted to get into the whole part of the specifications of watches regarding water resistance, because this is something that is quite confusing to people, because the watch companies are actually making it a little bit confusing. So I want to explain the differences in water resistance and what the meters of water resistance really mean, what you can actually do with your watch depending on what kind of water resistance it has. So one of the key specifications of watches is, of course, the water resistance rating. This tells the user something about how to treat his or her watch and also which activities you can actually use your watch for. So often water resistance is explained by meters. For example, 100 meters of water resistance. This particular watch here, we have the Grand Seiko Snowflake. If we look on the backside, we get, if you can just see it here, 10 bar. 10 bar is the same as 100 meters of water resistance. And we can, for example, take another Seiko. This is the SPB143. Here we actually see divers 200 meters of water resistance. So on a lot of watches, either on the dial or on the back case of the watch, you can actually see the specifications of the water resistance. So regarding water resistance, some watch companies actually use the metric system. Some watch companies, just like we saw on the Grand Seiko here, they use the bar. So 10 bar equals 100 meters of water resistance. It is the same with atmosphere. One atmosphere is 10 meters of water resistance, just like one bar is 10 meters of water resistance. This explains us how much water resistance the watch actually has. So you multiply bar or atmosphere with 10, and then you get the metric measurement. But you really have to be careful when you try to figure out how much you can actually use your watch for when we are talking about water resistance. Because is 50 meters of water resistance actually the same as you being able to dive down underwater, submerge underwater 50 meters? This is the Omega Speedmaster Professional manual wound. This is a 50 meter water resistant watch. So can you actually take this watch on your wrist and then dive down to 50 meters of depth in a ocean? Or for example, the Tag Heuer Monaco, which is 30 meter water resistant. Can you actually take this watch 30 meters down below the surface? And the answer is, of course, no. Because water resistance, when they use the metric system, isn't actually the equal to how deep you can go into a ocean if you go diving. This is actually something else. So they write the meters, but actually the meters, they tell us something else. For example, if we take the Speedmaster with 50 meters of water resistance, you can by no means actually go down 50 meters. I'm going to put a picture or a little overview on the screen now. This is from JS Watch Company in Reykjavik in Iceland. They have a really cool article about water resistance, and this is how they actually line up the different water resistances. And I'm going to link to this cool article down in the description if you want to visit the website and read more into this. So for example, a 50 meter water resistant watch, what can you do? You can definitely wear the watch while you're washing your hands. You can wear the watch in rain, not in direct rain, but in rain. Of course, you can wear the watch in moist situations. For example, if you are placed inside your car while it's being washed. And you should, in a lot of instances, also be able to actually wear a 50 meter water resistant watch in a shower. If it's only 30 meters, you can't wear it in the shower. You can't go diving with any of these watches. They must not go underwater, because what it's really all about is the pressure. So you know this, if you go underwater, for example, at the beach, or you go diving, or you're in a pool, and you dive maybe 1 or 2 or 3 meters down, you know you feel this pressure on your skull, on your body, and this is actually what the bar or atmosphere measurement calculation method is for. It's actually telling us how much pressure a watch can withstand, not how deep it can actually go. So if you want to have a watch where you can actually jump in the pool, not go diving several meters down, but actually just go a little below water, below the surface, you can definitely wear this Grand Seiko Snowflake, but it's water resistant, as we saw, to 10 bars, which, as I told you, equals 100 meters. So if you actually want to dive, if you want to actually go under the surface of water, you actually have to move beyond 100 meters of water resistance. You have to move into 200 meters and more meters, 200 meters plus. This is again the Seiko SPB 143. This is a dive watch. This is actually a dive watch. You can go diving with this watch, but again, with 200 meters of water resistance, you still have some limitations to the watch. Actually, the limitation is that you can't go deep diving. So you can't go very deep down. You can go scuba diving, but not deep water diving. If you want to go deep water diving, you have to move towards 300 meters of water resistance. And here we have the Omega Seamaster Professional. This is a 300 meter water resistant watch, so you can definitely wear this watch scuba diving, and you can also wear this watch if you go real deep diving. It's the same with the Tag Heuer Aqua Racer. This is also a 300 meter water resistant watch, as you can see here, 300 meters, 30 atmospheres or 30 bars if you want to actually calculate the pressure that this watch can withstand. And according to the article, a real dive watch, if you want to do real diving, not scuba diving, but actually deep water diving, you have to go between 300 and 1000 meters of water resistance. And at best, you actually go 500 meters and plus. So I hope this short video just explained to you that if you get 30 or 50 or 100, 150, 200, 300, and 500 meters of water resistance, it is not the same as you can actually dive down to that depth. So I can't go 30 meters down or 50 meters or 100 meters or 200 meters. It all has to do with the pressure that the watch can withstand, because it's built with gaskets, and also how the crystals and the backside of the watch is attached to the watch to withstand a certain amount of pressure. And if the pressure gets too much, actually you can risk that the crystal will pop out, or you will blow a gasket and water will get into the watch. So be very careful. I hope you enjoyed this video, just trying to very quickly explain what water resistance really is. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram and Facebook. I will see you very soon again. Thank you. Bye.